Hello, surprise, surprise. Really, 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 really good to be here. Hello, teens. I'm sure you must be wondering, what is Pastor Tunde doing on our video today? Well, I thought to surprise the teens. I thought to check in here. I haven't been here in ages. I haven't been here since the lockdown. And I just thought to come in, take the class today, and of course hope that it blesses you. I hope you've done a lot with the time during the lockdown. I hope you've been in touch with your friends. You know, hope you've taken care of the junior ones, and you know, also found time to get closer to God. Let me say thank you to your teachers, Sister Bisola, Sister Ejuro, Brother Kim, you know, and all these lovely people that serve in the teens church. I want us all to just say a big God bless you to all of them. If you have been blessed indeed by any of their teachings, you owe them a big God bless you. And of course, when hugs are allowed, you owe them a big hug also. So how are you all doing? What has it been like? Have you grown in this period? You know, the beauty of the teenage years is that it helps lay a foundation for the rest of your life. I'm saying this because it's almost like before you blink, you realize it's gone. You know, you're out of school, probably done your master's degree. Some of you will go on to do your PhD. But one thing you'll keep remembering is your teenage years. I mean, I'm over 49, I still remember my teenage years. And the decisions you take in this season of your life will go a long way to determining how you turn out in life. It's very, very, very important. So it's not fun time per se. It's, you know, planning time. It's time to ask God, you know, what would you have me do, you know, for the rest of my life? I mean, you're going into uni. What am I going to study? You know, what are the reasons for that? I mean, don't choose a course because it's the in thing or because your friends are doing it. Those are very, very flimsy, fickle reasons for doing anything. And you know, of course, in the last few weeks, we've touched on things like peer pressure, you know, the power, influence and stuff like that. And I do hope that has been a blessing to you. It's just important. Another one was approval addiction, I remember. And it's just important to be your own person. You understand that, and be single-minded in your decision-making as long as you know that God is with you on that. Somebody may be saying, all this you are saying is adult stuff. I'm only a teenager. You know, I still want to have fun. Please have all the fun you want to have. Discover yourself, but also know that today is the tomorrow that we discussed yesterday. And that is how fast time flies. All right. So I want us to talk quickly about today's lesson before we watch the video. We want to talk about the subject, impact, influence, you know, reputation, the power of a name. What does all that mean? You know, can God use me? Will God use me? What will God use me for? In fact, am I useful for anything? You know, and there may be people here who are even asking that question. And your self-esteem has been dealt such a heavy, heavy, massive blow. You know, I think that this will be a blessing to you. I think that you will realize that everyone is unique. It's the psalmist who said that I am fearfully and wonderfully made. And that should ring, amen, in your subconscious and in your system. God took his time to make you. You are made for a reason. You are made for a specific reason. You are specific for a specific reason. You are special, irrespective of what anyone might say or anyone might think, or in fact, irrespective of what people have said to you over the years and over time that may have damaged your sense of self-worth and self-esteem. You know, I trust God for restoration and repair and, you know, hope. And I also pray that this will be a blessing to you, that when you when you come out of this season, you know, you are all fired up to do things that will glorify God's name, to also do things that will stand you in good stead for the future, and of course, make the right decisions. We are all about decision making. In Jeremiah 1 and verse 5, if you open there in your Bibles, Jeremiah 1 and verse 5, God talking to Jeremiah, he said, "Before you were born, while you were yet in your mother's womb, I knew you, and I set you apart, even as a prophet unto nations." One thing that must always encourage you and give you strength is that God knew you even before you knew yourself. God knew you even before you knew yourself. You are a born winner. You are standing today. A lot of teens have died over the years, gotten hooked on drugs and all sorts of vices, you know, and even where you fell, you've gotten up by the grace of God, or you are getting up by the grace of God. You are born a winner. You have fought so many battles you don't know, and you have been victorious. Let that encourage you. God has a specific, detailed purpose for you. I want you to sit back, relax, watch this video, and then let's talk about it after, before we round up. God bless you. I'll see you after this.
What's up, Switch? My name is Gavin Espinoza. I get to be a youth pastor here at Switch, and I am so excited to be with you here tonight. You need to know something, that you guys, right here as Switch students, are part of the most powerful generation, where I believe you have access to more power than any people your age in the history of the world. So I need you to do something for me right now. I need you to turn to the person next to you and say, "You are powerful." Perfect. Now you need to go to your B-list friend, your second choice on the other side, and since they're your second choice, I need you to get real into it and say, "You are powerful." So good, so good. There we go. I believe that you guys are so powerful, that God's going to do a lot in you and through you if you just allow him to. And the truth is, growing up, I had a little bit of a fascination with superheroes. Like, yeah, I had a toy chest filled with 50 different action figures. But what you need to know is, out of the 50 action figures, only 5 of them were not a Batman action figure, because Batman was my absolute favorite. And you want to know why? Because Batman didn't have superpowers. He was rich. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can get down with that. That is good. He was not bitten by some radioactive spider. No, he was not some freak, weird scientific experiment, but he had money, and that was great. He inherited billions of dollars from his parents, but what made him special is what he decided to do with what he had. He decided to protect his city from all kinds of evil supervillains, and that's what mattered. You might say to me, "Gavin, if I had billions of dollars, I would have bat cars and really cool gadgets and do lots of cool things with it too." But you don't. But what you do have is something very specific that God has given you that you're supposed to use to impact your world around you. Right now, we're going to look at a story in the Old Testament. That's in the first half of the Bible. And this book is called Esther. Now, she is one of my favorite leaders in the Old Testament. And I'm going to kind of sum up her story. And it goes something like this. There once was a king named Xerxes. He was rich and powerful. And one day, his queen disrespected him in front of the entire kingdom. No good. So what did he do? He had her removed as queen. So then he searched out for another queen, and he fell in love with this woman named Esther. Now, the name is significant. Names have meanings. In fact, Esther's name meant star. Some people even said, "I am a hiding place." Names are significant. Remember that. But one day, this evil man named Haman came up with this idea. He hated the Jewish people, so he wanted to have them all killed. So he convinced the king to sign an order to do so. Plot twist coming at you right now. Esther was Jewish, but Haman and the king did not know that. In fact, she was terrified to tell them that I'm one of the Jewish people because they had the right to kill her. But she got courage from her uncle Mordecai. He tells her in Esther chapter 4, he says, "If you keep quiet at a time like this, deliverance and relief for the Jews will arise from some other place." It will arise from some other place, meaning God could choose someone else if you don't say yes, but you and your relatives will die. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for such a time as this. For such a time as this. Guess what? Esther heard those words and she did something about it. She took a stand right where she was at, and she's Bible famous for her courage because she stood up and told a king when really it wasn't her place to do so. And in fact, when she did that, it saved an entire nation and changed the course of history for her people. You see, God doesn't always use the people you would expect, but sometimes he puts you in the right place at the right time to make a big difference. Throughout history, what you got to realize is names were special. Names were powerful. You know, when they named a child, it was actually the hopes of everything this kid might one day become. It meant something. It was something special. It was representative of everything you were supposed to accomplish in life. Names were powerful. Everybody say, it's all in a name. It's all in a name. We're going to look at a few different names in the Bible. First, we're going to look at Moses, whose name meant to draw out, like draw out from water, because that's what happened. He was actually found near a river, and that's what his name meant. Moses was adopted, full of insecurities of all kinds. But let me tell you something. One day, he had an encounter with God. And that encounter with God changed him. It changed him so much that he was able to overcome those uncertainties. He's able to overcome all his own excuses and problems he had with himself and say, yes, God, I can be used. And because he was willing to do what he was supposed to do in the time and place he was called, God used him to deliver an entire people out of slavery. Next, we're going to look at my boy, David. David is my favorite hero in the Bible. David, his name means beloved or friend. You know the story of David. He was one of the youngest, didn't mean a whole lot. What did they do? They put him out in the field to shepherd, to watch over the sheep. But as he was watching over the sheep, that's when the lion and the bear came and attacked. And it made him ready for one day. One day when he would step out to front and stand toe-to-toe with Goliath the giant, and he would defeat him. Where you're at right now as a teenager matters. What you're doing with what God puts you at, it can prepare you for what's going to happen in the future, because David became known as the man after God's own heart, and it's from his time as a teenager where he got those habits and how to seek God. What you need to know is God has you where you are for a reason. David was a conquering king and won battle after battle after battle. Next, we'll look at Abraham. Abraham, his name means father of multitudes. What's Abraham known for? He had an unwavering faith in God. And because of his faith, God said, I'm going to bless the entire earth through you and through your descendants. One of those descendants, his name is Jesus. Jesus, the one who would save the entire world, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, all because one man followed God and did what he told him to. The little small things that God's asking you to do, if you can be faithful in those, who knows what it can lead to. You see, you are powerful. Your name matters. Names, it's representative of who you are, of what you would accomplish. N-A-M-E, name. N, notions. You see, I believe that God's given you thoughts, ideas. He's put them inside you. Some of them are so big it even scares you a little bit. But if those ideas, those thoughts just stay in your head, it's never going to have the impact that it could. That's why your notions, your ideas, they have to lead to actions. Actions. Actions are important because it's our actions, not your intentions, that actually have an impact in the world. In Matthew, it says this. It says, yes, just as you can identify a tree by its fruit, so you can identify people by our actions. Actions end up leading you into a direction. In fact, they move you. And your actions move you either closer to the destiny that you know God has for you, or it can lead you down a path that you never really intended to go down. Your actions move you in a specific direction. And when you allow those thoughts, those actions to move you in the right direction, you're not just going to live your best life, but you're going to live God's best life for you. And that will impact eternity. Eternity. Let's see what the Bible says about your eternity. It says this, in the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. You see, when you do these things, when you live out your name and it goes towards your purpose, you're not glorifying yourself, but it's about bringing glory to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords so that all men will know that he has done something special in you. So what does that mean? What does that mean right now? Where you're at? What can you do? There's actually an author and a speaker by the name of John Gordon. He says this, that there's a secret to overnight success. Any of you want to know the secret to becoming an overnight success? He says exactly what it is. He says, the secret to becoming an overnight success is for you to start doing something today. Start doing something today. You work really hard for years. You show up every day, you do the work, you see yourself as an artist who's dedicated to your craft with a desire to get better. You try new things, you fail, you improve, then you grow. What you gotta understand is you gotta start today. You've gotta start exactly where you're at. Then one day, after consistently doing the right things, everyone will look at the huge impact you've had in your sphere of influence. So you've got to start at home. It starts with your family. It starts with your switch group. It starts in your school, in your neighborhood, how you act. Maybe you know that person at school, that person who not a lot of people talk to, but God puts you in their world for a reason, because you can let them know just how valuable they are. Maybe you've got a passion for kids, maybe specifically special needs kids. You can have a huge impact by serving week in and week out in life kids. And by you being there, what it does is it shows a family what the love of Jesus looks like by you taking care of their kids. Maybe for you, you've got a job and you're earning money because you're working hard. Or maybe you've saved up your allowances or birthday money and you've been wanting to buy something for yourself. But maybe God's calling you to do something different, something that's weird, something that's going to make an impact in those around you. You've got to use what you have. God puts you in your family, in your school, in your city, in this room for a reason. And if you want to step into all that God has for you, you got to start today. Switch. You are powerful. You're powerful. And I know when you decide to step out, you can make a difference. You can achieve those dreams that God has put inside your heart and inside your mind. Bow your heads and pray with me. God, I thank you. I thank you for these students. God, I thank you that you brought them here in this room. God, I pray for those right now who's hearing what this message is all about, and you're going to speak to them. Because Switch students, I know there's some of you in this room that you've had these ideas. You know exactly what I'm talking about these dreams that God has given you. Dreams so big that you've maybe even been afraid to tell your friends. But guess what? Tonight you're going to have the boldness to start and do something about it. Because you recognize, you have an eye to see those around you that are hurting, those around you that are in need, and you know you can do something, even if it's something small about it, you can make a difference. You can show them who Jesus is by the way you treat them, by the way you love them, by the way you interact with them. And you know that when you go home, you're ready to start. Start small, but be consistent because you can make a difference in someone's life just by trying to make their day by showing them the love of God. And Switch, if you're ready, you're ready to commit to taking that step, to doing something, to stop waiting for that one day in the future, but you're gonna make it count today right now, and you want us to pray for boldness for you. Lift your hand high in this room. Yeah, I see hands going up everywhere. Yeah, God, I pray for these students. I thank you. I thank you for what you're doing inside of them. I thank you for the dreams that you have put inside their heart. God, I pray that you give them the boldness to share those dreams with someone tonight and start doing the actions that's going to move them into the future that you have for them that will impact eternity. With your head still bowed and your eyes still closed, I believe there's another group of you in this room. And you hear us talk about power, but you feel powerless. You feel like you can't do it. And the truth is that God never created you to be able to do it by yourself on your own power. Because God created us with the need for something greater. And that need is relationship with Him. You see, in John chapter 15, Jesus tells us that greater love has no man than this, that someone can lay down their life for their friend. And that's exactly what Jesus did for you, and he did for me. Because we're imperfect people. And those imperfections, they separate us from God. But God said, you know what? That's not how I intended. I want to be close to you. I want to hold you. I know that you're not perfect. I know the dark things about you that you wish you've never done, that you wish no one ever knew about you. I know those, but I still call you my masterpiece. And he's calling you tonight. He's calling you right now saying, I know who you are and I know your past, but your past doesn't matter to me because I have a future for you. And that future is available through a relationship with Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So Switch, tonight in this room, you may be here for the first time or you may have been here 1,000 times, but you're ready to say yes to a relationship with Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. That's you. Raise your hand high right now.
Amen. Welcome back. Let me guess, that video blessed you. Yeah, that video blessed you. And so the question is, what is the power in a name. What is the effect, the impact I have or can have on this world? You mean God is going to use me to do great things? You know, there's a parable, or there's a story in the Bible in Matthew 25 from around the 14th verse where it talks about a master who was going on a long journey, and then he called his three servants and gave them different amounts. The Bible calls them talents. That was the currency of the day. He gave them different amounts, and then he said to them to do business with it. He gave to one 5, he gave to another 2 talents, and he gave to another 1 talent. You could call it 5 naira, 2 naira, 1 naira. Anyway, the guy who had 5 went and traded with it and made an extra 5. The guy who had 2 went and traded with it and made an extra 2. The guy who had 1 went and traded with it. Sorry, I got that wrong. The guy who had 1 went and buried his treasure. And when the master came back and asked them to give account, the guy who had 5 came and said, "Hey, I made 5 more." And he got such a huge commendation from his master. His master praised him. In fact, his master committed to him more responsibilities. The guy who had 2 came back and said, "I made 2 more." Oh, his master said, "Well done," gave him more responsibilities. The guy who had 1, he was full of excuses. He said, I know you're a wicked man. I know you don't reap where you sow. I was afraid, so I hid my talent, and I've brought back your talent. What is your excuse today? Are you afraid? Are you unsure? Are you bitter and angry because somebody hurt you? Or are you complaining that you don't have so many talents? Because the guy with 1 talent could have seen what the others had and complained and said, since I don't have 5 talents or 2 talents, I'm just going to do nothing with this. That never works. Everything in life grows. And so you may be here questioning yourself and asking yourself, "I don't have much. I can't do much. I only have this little skill or that little skill." I want you to learn from that story. When you start in life, and that really is always the big deal, start. Get off your feet. Whatever you sense in your heart, God is using you to do. Whatever your passions are, whatever your likes are, hear me, those are the instruments God is going to use to touch the world around you. Trust me, God isn't going to use anything else. He's not going to come down as an angel or like an angel from heaven and hold your hands, you know, and do stuff with you. No, he's going to use the gifts that he has put in you. Okay, so let's do a little recap from that class. I mean, I think I particularly like, you know, the superhero story, and the teacher said his favorite superhero was Batman, because Batman didn't necessarily have any special superpowers, but he was very favorite superhero was Batman, but not because of any superpowers, but because Batman was rich. Batman inherited billions of dollars from his family. Batman could have decided to just rest on his laurels and say, "Hey, I'm just going to have fun, you know, enjoy life, you know, go to parties with my friends, we'll go on my yacht, we'll go cruising and sailing and, you know, doing all that stuff." But Batman chose to guard his city. Batman chose to be an influence on his city. Batman chose to channel his passion to touching lives in his community. That was his name. let me say that your name is not necessarily Tunde or Wale or any of those things. You were given those names because your parents or the people who named you believed that God had filled you up with dreams and hopes and passions and great things. It is your responsibility to find out what those things are and begin to do something about them. That is your real name. Your real name is the impact you leave on the world. Your real name are the lives that you touch. Some people may never actually remember what you're called, but they'll never forget that guy who helped them. They'll never forget that guy who encouraged them. They'll never forget that guy who put an arm around their shoulders when they needed help. They'll never forget that guy who sent them a small gift, or that girl. Yes, she was a teenager, he was a teenager, but the little thing they did was so touching. The Bible is full of people who lived out their names. You're talking about someone like Moses, whose name was drawn out. I mean, this guy was drawn out of water, but his real name, his real calling, was to draw God's people out of slavery. And so he led them out of Egypt and began to lead them towards the promised land. That was his real name. Your real name is not what you write on in front of your book. No, no, no. Your real name are the hopes and the dreams and the passions that God has put in you. You have people like David, people like Abraham. Abraham was a father of many nations. And even though life happened to him, and for so many decades he didn't have a child, he insisted that his name was going to touch the earth. And God blessed him. And through him, many nations came, descendants came. And one of those descendants, you and I know him, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. That descendant is still touching the earth today. He's still touching the world today. And so I want you to think about your name. There's an acronym for name here. It says notions, which are your ideas, which are your hopes. I mean, what are the things you like? Somebody here likes graphic design. You like dancing, you know. You like helping out in your estate or in your community. In fact, you like taking care of your younger ones, you know. This may just look like normal, regular stuff to you, but it's important you started to see yourself as special and started to behave that way. And started to think that there may be more to this thing that I just like doing. God may want to use it to touch lives. When you know what your notion is, or your ideas are, or your passions are, the next step is to take action. That is the A in name, is to take action. Do something. Start in your small little way. If the guy who had one talent had taken action, he would have had a second one. And for all you care, by now, he would have had, you know, 50 talents. I mean, there may be somebody here, you know, God has asked you to start something, maybe on Instagram, maybe a program or something. And I say, no, 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 I only have one follower, I only have two. Who is going to follow me anyway? Start. So give action to it. And then that action will move you in a certain direction. That action will begin to flesh out what your particular skills are. You begin to get better in doing what you are doing. And that is the secret behind expertise. Anybody called an expert just stayed on the same thing for long enough. There's power in focus. And when you do that, it will touch eternity and it will make a mark for God in the sands of time. So I've spoken about notion, action, moving in a direction, eternity, and also start today. So when I say take action, I don't mean next week or in 2 weeks' time. Start today. I'm going to leave you with an assignment before we watch the worship video and sign out. And that assignment is this. I want you to spend the week thinking about how God is going to use you, praying about how God is going to use you. I want you to write down notes. And then I want you to begin to do something about them. I want you to share it with your friends. It's not about keeping secrets or not letting people know your business. It's about accountability. Sometimes we help each other and encourage each other by just letting each other know the projects we're working on. So let that be the case. You have a friend, you talk all the time. Go beyond mundane things and talk about serious stuff. Let them be able to check on how you're doing with your project. Talk to your parents about it. Let them help you. And I'm sure you will be on the way to greatness. I want to say a big thank you for your time today. As we watch the worship video and sign out, I want to say a word of prayer for you, or with you. Lord, I'm asking that you bless the teenager that is watching this video right now, that you touch them in your own special way, that you heal them in their emotions and wherever they may be feeling hurt, that you restore them, that you help them live out their names, that you impress upon their hearts your will for them, and that they are courageous enough to take action about it. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. I have really and thoroughly enjoyed this, and I hope you have. I look forward to seeing you again at some point when churches resume or when in-person services resume. But please always show up on Sundays for your lessons. Invite your friends. Let the world know about it. Tell your parents you were blessed today because Pastor Tunde took the lesson. Tell them what you learned and what you will do about it. I love you so much. And I look forward to seeing you again. Enjoy the video and then enjoy the week. God bless you.
The you. Universe is held within your hands, and all the earth bows down at your command. The wonder of creation will testify to all you've done. From age to age, your promises have stood. You reign as king, just like you said you would. And every generation will testify to all you've done, to all you've done. To God be the glory, to God be the glory. Oh, you have done great things, you will never change. To God be the glory.
Oh, yes.
The deaf can hear, the broken live again. The blind can see, the sinner is a friend. And love's renovation will testify to all you've done.
Sing our hearts.
Our hearts. Kingdom knows no end. And
Silence! You think this is funny, eh? You can get the deadly coronavirus.
The gorilla virus?
No, the coronavirus. Do you know what will happen when you do? Do you?
Huh, what will happen?
You will bring the coronavirus home and then infect everyone. Mommy will be sick, no more jollof rice.
Huh?
Daddy will be sick, no more going out to see movies.
Oh no, not the movies, no!
Even worse, the government will come and take Mommy and Daddy away.
You're just making it up.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
See for yourself.
Okay, it's real. It's real. What should we do?
The coronavirus is out there. We should stay at home for now. Always wash our hands with soap and water so we can prevent it from spreading.
Boo!
Stay home, stay safe from all of us at Ant Hill Studios.